Guys, before the video starts, my new song, Just For You, came out today. I've been trying to find a way to make it work. Go check it out on Spotify, add it to your playlist, link in the description. Don't forget to follow Lil Pitchy on Spotify as well. I appreciate you guys' support so freaking much. It's fun to release music. Ow, I hurt myself. Today, we're looking at old bands versus new bands. For old bands, we have Maroon 5. I've had you so many times. They've changed so much. I want more. A little bit pitchy there. I don't mind standing every day. Out on your corner in the pouring rain. This is an excellent song, though. The production's great, too, actually. It sounds good still. Very slick pop rock. And here for new bands, we have Magic. Can I have your daughter for the rest this of my is a sick say song. Yes, say yes, 'cause I need to know. You say I'll never get your blessing till the day I die. It's a pretty cheesy music video. But the answer is no. Something has happened, like, you can't really lip sync too much in music videos anymore like that. Like, act out a sequence. Like a conversation like that. It's kind of cringe, but I like it. So as much as I love Rude, I actually think that song is better than She Will Be Loved. Maroon 5, even at that time, had just way more awesome songs. I don't have as many Magic songs that I really enjoy. So it's gonna have to go to old bands. And here for old bands, we have Red Hot Chili Peppers. It's understood that Hollywood sells Californication. This would almost work as an ironic music video now. Just the awful graphics. Man, they didn't like shirts. I guess they were very allergic or something. If you're very allergic, I can understand shirtlessness. I actually have to use a specific type of cleaner so that I don't get allergic reactions on my clothes. Now you know, big scoop. Here for new bands, we have Imagine Dragons. This is writing my poems for the few that look at me. They're so well produced. Like, the music production quality is crazy. From the brain, seeing the beauty through the. All the sound design is really sick.
I love it, he's also shirtless. What is going on here?
The Red Hot Chili Peppers were cooler, still are cooler, and their lyrics are really strong. However, on the musical side, I find that Imagine Dragons have more interesting things going on. And the vocals are more impressive as well. You can say what you want about, what's his name? Anthony Kiedis, I think that's how I say it.
Anthony Kiedis.
I just find his voice a little bit boring. How long are the ball? He never sings any high, and there's no distortion or anything either. There's just not a lot going on with his voice. Difficult. I think for me personally, I would put on Imagine Dragons before Red Hot Chili Peppers, just as a vibe. So I'm gonna put it to new bands. But if I were to think about which band is technically the best, it might go to Red Hot Chili Peppers. It's hard. It's a toss-up. I'm giving it to freaking Imagine Dragons. And I'll just kind of ignore the bad lyrics that sometimes happen. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name's Joe from Roomie Official, and my new song, Just For You, came out today. Lil Pitchy on Spotify, link in the description. I'm just gonna keep saying that today because I'm excited. Here for old band, we had Led Zeppelin, Kashmir.
That's a lot of phaser in that guitar.
Is this like scatting? Is he just making stuff up? That's hilarious. It's like jazz rock almost. It feels so improvised. Okay, here we got 21 Pilots stressed out for new bands. I'm sure the clique will be angry that we're playing this song. They only like the non-hit songs, right? I can see if you really like a band that it gets annoying if people just play one song from them all the time. However, we do it anyway. Ha! You've been trolled, clique. We still love you. Okay, I'm gonna have to give this one to 21 Pilots. To be fair, I'm not super familiar with Led Zeppelin. Let me know in the comments if there's any Led Zeppelin songs I need to listen to in a future video. Maybe they got another song where the singer goes boo 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 and not just ba 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 ba. That would be cool. Here we got Jackson 5 for old bands.
This live?
Doesn't sound like a studio recording. That is so sick. I know I love a song when I get irritated when it gets cut off in the compilation. I'm like, I wanted more of that. Here we got new band, Panic at the Disco, Death of Bachelor Band. They used to be amazing. This was a really cool song, like the trap beats together with the horns and the jazzy vibe. Amazing. I guess what he was going for was a trap version of Sinatra and the Rat Pack and that stuff. Even with that, you can't really compete with Jackson 5. I'm also gonna give myself the out by saying that Panic at the Disco was not a band at this point. It's just Brendon Urie. So as far as bands are concerned, gotta give it to Jackson 5. So that's another one for the old bands. Here for old bands, we have Fleetwood Mac's Dreams.
Oh yeah.
This is the band that had the one guy that joined a cult. I think we talked about that in this video. Pretty scary stuff, guys. This song just chugs along. It's like background music in a commercial or something. We didn't even get to the chorus. What? Thunder only happens when it's raining. Okay, now we have the chorus. And here for new band, we have the 1975. I love the 1975. So good. It's voice. I'm gonna have to give this one to the 1975. Super interesting, both lyrically and the music was really nice too. Here for old bands, we have ABBA, or ABBA. In Sweden, we say ABBA. 17. Iconic piano things. So ABBA had a very interesting approach. They really liked to dub everything, which means you record everything twice. So I think even the drums on a lot of songs have like two layers. They were early on the ball with a lot of experimental sound design stuff. And here we have for new bands, Wolf Alice. Beautifully unconventional. I have not heard this. Wolf Alice are a British alternative rock band from London, formed in 2010 as an acoustic duo. Now they have a bassist and a drummer as well. Congratulations on forming a band, guys. You think I'm so sorry, girl. Who is she trying to look like? Girls that don't go out. Marilyn Munn show. That was funny. It's good. Very basic. Kind of like a different twist on the early Maroon 5 stuff, like super rhythmical, guitar pop. Also kind of basic in some ways. I'm not super into it, to be honest. I think the style is cool, but that particular song didn't speak to me. I'm gonna have to give it to ABBA. Old, amazing, freaking band. I swear I'm dropping things more. Maybe it's because I had my birthday.
I'm getting old now.
Here for old bands, we have The Temptations, Treat Her Like a Lady. Amazing suit, yes. Amazing voice too. This is so up my alley. Bruh, I love that. I've never heard that before, but that's going in the playlist. And here for new bands, we have Silk Sonic, Leave the Door Open. Have not heard them either. Oh wait, I know this. It's Bruno Mars and Anderson .Paak. I didn't know they had a name like Silk Sonic. How did I miss that? I think Silk Sonic has a lot of potential to become a great band and release a lot of sick songs. That particular song doesn't speak to me super much. I enjoy it when I hear it, but I don't seek it out. I will definitely seek out that old song. That is unbelievable. I'm gonna give it to old bands. For old bands, we have Van Halen's Jump. Classic. We talked about this song in this video about what lyrics are about. This one has a bit of a dark twist to it. It is a very good song. Pure pick-me-up magic. And knowing what the lyrics are about, you're like, oh, should I really feel this good listening to this? And here we got a new band, 5 Seconds of Summer. She Looks So Perfect. This is a guilty pleasure of mine. I really like this. Production's amazing too. The amount of endorphins I get from this song. I mean, that was pretty cool. I freaking love 5 Seconds of Summer. I think they're great, but I gotta give it to Van Halen. The more I think about it, they have a lot of great songs and they're just a very iconic band. Plus, Van Halen weren't as much catering to young girls, which is a plus for me. Boy band lyrics are an acquired taste. I can live with them, but I'd rather have people sing about something else. Maybe not the lyrics of Jump. There's other Van Halen songs with great lyrics. For old bands, we have Kraftwerk. Is that how you say that? Kraftwerk?
Kraftwerk.
That's so cool. Ooh, okay. What's that about? Okay. Places where, I guess, bombs fell. It's in the air for you and me. Anyway, we got a new band, C2C, Down the Road. Wow, this looks very old, but... I like that vocal sample. That's fun. This guy looks like Jesse Eisenberg so much. I wonder if they're actually doing that live. I kind of feel like they're not. These are two very automated bands. But Kraftwerk at least kind of had some singing. The guy to the left was kind of like, meh, 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 meh. I'm not going to base my judgment on whether they sang live or not, though. I thought the new band was a little bit mumbo-jumbo-ish. They didn't really say a lot. It was mainly just samples and a fun vibe. There was more songwriting going on than the Kraftwerk stuff, which is my preference, at least. I'm going to put it over there. The old bands are running away with the scores here. We got 6-3. Here for old bands, we have U2, With or Without You. Those iconic guitars. If you don't know, the Edge was very famous for these delay guitars. Very cool. He does sing really well in this one, I have to say. And for new bands, we have The Vamps' Somebody to You, which is also, again, a boy band. Look at me now, I'm falling. I can't even talk. This stuttering, this crowd of heart keeps shaking. Oh, 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 now! All I wanna be, all I ever wanna be, yeah. This is a great song. I know there's Swedish songwriters behind this. It's Carl Falk and few other people. I really like The Vamps. I can't give it to them though. At this point in time, I feel like they're way less of a real act and more of an industry thing where they work with a lot of songwriters and stuff, which is fine. It's fine to do that. But U2 kind of carved a path for themselves in a way that's really impressive. And a lot of their songs are really good. And I'm gonna have to give it to old bands once again. I really like The Vamps though. Like I've listened a lot to them. Probably more than I've listened to U2, to be honest. For old bands, we have Bon Jovi, Living on a Prayer. I love how their trademark was to talk box guitars. They're having fun with it. It's less cringy if you're like having fun with the glam rock stuff. A lot of them took themselves so seriously at this time. And for new bands, we have Bon Iver's Hollow Sea. That is some Mickey Mouse style singing. It's very atmospheric. I like it. I want to listen to this late at night, like driving or something. These are so different. How can you even compare these two? To be honest, I just can't. I like both of it. I'm gonna give half points to each side here. It's like comparing apples to your mom. I love them both too much, you know what I mean? Here for old bands, we have Parliament and Funkadelic, Bring the Funk. Hey. It's so funny singing about the genre you're doing. Groove's like crazy. And here we got a new band, Alabama Shakes, Sound and Color. Kind of down the same school of thought for sure. Different vibe. Good actor. The most enjoyable thing for me right here, even though these songs are also pretty different, they're easier to compare to me. I'm gonna give it to old bands. Give up the points for the funk, you know. Here for old bands, we have Blondie, Heart of Glass. Me dancing. She looks like she doesn't want to be there. That backlight is crazy. For backlighting, you put a light behind the subject. I do that a little bit sometimes, but this is extreme. Her hair is just like a sun. Here for new band, we have Paramore, Hard Times. I don't know if it's because I'm expecting more from Hayley Williams because she's such an amazing singer, but that was not the best vocal performance, I felt like. Even when you're singing in that range, you can make it more interesting. She's not doing a lot with the tone or anything. It's just kind of flattened. And the production's also super basic. It's just like, oh, here's a guitar, here's some drums. Okay, we're done. I'm still gonna have to give it to Paramore. I think they got a lot of great songs. Blondie, not as much for me. Okay, guys, get here for more Music VS videos, get here for music commentary videos, and today, the old bands won against the new bands. Once again, check out Lil Peachy's new song, Just For You, link in the description. It came out today. Let me know what you thought about it in the comments, and I'll see you tomorrow in another daily video. Thanks, bye.